Local this evening, the United States Navy christened and launched the future USS Wichita today at the Marinette Marine shipyard. However, the littoral combat ship program has endured its growing pains. Local 5's Steve Dent looks into the changes the Navy is making after several of these ships had experienced mechanical problems.
I christen thee Wichita.
LCS 13, part of the Freedom class built at Marinette Marine. And with that, Lockheed Martin put ship number 7 of the Freedom class in the water.
This is by far the best ship that they've put out of that building of this class. And that's a tribute to what the men and women in this shipyard are doing.
But so far, 4 littoral combat ships have experienced engineering problems after the Navy commissioned these ships, including all 3 of the Freedom class.
We have very good lessons learned, very good feedback through the Navy crews. They tell us what is going well, and they tell us where they're struggling a little. We work real hard in the shipyard side through design and production to correct those so that we don't put out more ships with any issues.
The main issue has been operator error because of new sophisticated technology.
We highly automated these ships, and we gave them capability to do things where sailors aren't, all with the touchpad, touch screens, and everything else.
So the Navy will retrain engineers and could use the first 2 ships of both the Freedom and Independence classes for training.
With everything you do, whether it's in the military or in a civilian capacity, it's always crawl, walk, run.
And while there are growing pains, these ships are important for the future of the U.S. Navy.
With such a shallow draft, you're talking 13 to 14 feet, we have an opportunity to go into ports where our brother warships don't have an opportunity to go.
In the meantime, shipbuilding will continue at Marinette Marine. Keeping it local in Marinette, Steve Dent, Local 5.